Today, I am here with fourth lecture of research methodology class, and the topic would be variables, operational definitions, theory and conceptual framework. So the learning outcome for today's lecture would be to understand different types of variables, how we define them, how we provide the operational definitions of our variables, how we develop theories, theoretical development, and how we develop conceptual framework in our research. So this is very important lecture while you are doing your final year project. That is very important to understand these concepts in detail. So without any further delay, let's start with our lecture today. I'm Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi, your instructor for research methodology subject. Okay, let's start with the understanding of variable. A variable is something which changes its value with respect to the given conditions, or it is the outcome or parameters to be estimated in our research. Okay, so this is usually something we are interested to measure in. Okay, so the object of inquiry treated as a variable and is usually defined as an attribute that takes on a range of values, means that the value may be differ or varies with respect to individual characteristics. Okay, so it means that the variable is something which changes its value based on the given conditions. Okay, now for example, a piece of social research may be interested in several variables of a group of people. It means that it is not only one variable you are interested in, maybe there is more than one variable we are looking or we are trying to estimate in our research. For example, individual age, individual gender characteristics, or the political views, or any other characteristics we want to measure in our social sciences based research. In our research we use this type of variable, but in one variable or in one research maybe we can use more than one variable for conceptualizing any framework. Okay, now let's move to some given definitions of variable. A variable is observable characteristics that vary among individual. That is very simple definition. Another definition is provided: a characteristic that varies in value of magnitude along which an object, individual or group may be categorized, such as age or income. We categorize individual groups based on these characteristics. Okay, that is also named as a variable. Okay, now another definition is a measurable trait or characteristic that is subject to change under different conditions. So all these are very simple definitions of variable, but in simple, this is our outcome. We are interested to estimate these parameters, so they are called variables. So we want to figure out what are their outcome or what are their values in under our given conditions. So that is a variable. But variables, for example, if I'm interested to study gender equality, so there is a possibility male have high salaries than the females, or females have a high salary than the male. It means that the salary under a certain economic condition under gender equality is a variable. So this is a complete definition or understanding of a variable. Now, once we know that variable is something we are interested to measure, now the second question will come into my mind: how we can measure them and what are the different types of variables available in our research? For very basic understanding, we can measure variables with the different techniques, but these techniques or these methods I will explain in another lecture when we will discuss about how to develop a questionnaire or scales for measuring any variable. At that time we will cover the part of the measurement of any variable, but here I am more interested to tell you how different types of variables we have in our research, how many different types. But basically, if I divide them into very basic categories, then we have these simple categories: dependent variable, independent variable, moderator or mediator, or control variable. These are very basic definitions of or categorization of variables involved in our research. Okay, now dependent variable, with the name it is very clear, it is a variable whose value is depending on other variables. Okay, the value of one variable, if it is dependent on other, it is called a dependent variable. Okay. Now, a dependent variable is one that has been identified as the manifestation of some social phenomena and that is caused by or associated with or other independent variable. This is the definition I took from Social Research Glossary. Okay, so very simple, dependent variable is a variable whose value is dependent on other variables. Okay, on the other side, the independent variables are those which cause change in the dependent variable. Okay, they are not being influenced by any other variable in the model or in the study, but they cause influence on the other variable. That is why independent variables are sometimes known as causal or explanatory variable. So dependent variable whose value is dependent on other variables, and independent variables are those which cause change in any other variable in the model, is called independent variable. Okay, so it's very clear. For example, the example I was taking from day one to my class. So digital marketing has an influence on sales. It means that the more we have digital marketing, the more would be the sales. So means that if we add digital marketing, spending on digital marketing, it will cause an effect, and as a result, the sale would be increased. Okay. So this is a causal relationship. Digital marketing causes a change in sales. So that is a very simple example of dependent and independent variable. Here, digital marketing is independent and sales is a dependent variable. Okay. Therefore, now let's discuss about the mediator variable. Mediator variables are those which basically intermediates between independent and dependent variable. For example, these mediators are the one which explains the relationship between dependent and independent variable. So if I study that mediator variables is the variable that cause mediation between dependent and independent. And in other words, it explains the relationship between the dependent and independent variable. Let me give you one example. We already know that this digital marketing has an effect on sales. But what if I introduce product image? What digital marketing is doing, it is building an image of that product, and that is why people are buying this product online. Okay, so means that the relationship between digital marketing and sales can be explained with the project, with the help of project product image. For example, if I explain it further, digital marketing enhances the sales, but this sales is increased through a process. What is that process? Mean that when we do digital marketing, the people, they have a product image, the product image has been developed, and then people will love to buy that product. So it means that the product image can play a mediating role here. Let me give you one more example. Here, many of us, we know that we have a criteria, for example, the salary, the amount of salary. If the salary is more, it means that we have more satisfaction. The employee satisfaction would be higher if we have the salary, higher salary. So salary is influencing the individual's or employee's satisfaction. But what if I say this direct relationship is explained by some other variable? Why? Because salary is money and satisfaction is something we perceive. So this cannot be done with the money only. Means that I don't eat money. It is the utilization of that money that gives me satisfaction. If the more salary, it means that I can maintain more positive social status. I can buy a few products for me that provide me satisfaction. It means that the utilization of that money is basically explaining that relationship. Okay, high salary and high satisfaction. But why? Because we can buy so many products or so many things, or we have we can maintain a better social status. That is why we can be more satisfied. So this relationship between independent and dependent variable is being explained with the help of mediator variables. Okay, so this is called mediation. If I go deep into the theory of mediation, there should be two major points to be noted while we are dealing with the theory. The first, it explains the reasons of relationship between dependent and independent variable. You understand me that it explains why the relationship between independent and dependent has happened and what is the reason. And the second one, it must be causal result of independent variable and causal antecedent of dependent variable. Means that there would be logically or empirically, there will be a relationship between independent and the mediator and the mediator and dependent variable. For example, if I give this example again here. So if you see digital marketing, it have a positive relationship with the product image. Means that the more you do the digital marketing, your product image would be enhanced. And as a result, product image will enhance the sales. So it means that the product image and sales have a causal relationship. So digital marketing influences product management, product image, and the product image will enhance the sales. So that is the relationship for mediation, that is mandatory. So causal relationship is must for both of them. Okay, now these two relationships are very important. So it explains the reasons of relationship between independent and dependent variable, and secondly, it must be causal result of dependent and independent variables. Okay, so antecedent of dependent but causal relationship of independent variable. Now on the other hand, the moderator, this is another kind of intervening variable. A moderator is a variable that affects the strength of relationship between predictor and criteria, means that independent and dependent variable, it strengthen the relationship or weaken the relationship, means that it influence the relationship between dependent and independent variable. How it is being done? Let me give you one example. Moderator contextualize the effect between dependent and independent variable. That is very simple thing. Okay, so it means that it gives you why the strength and how the strength of the relationship can be enhanced, and the context should be explained. Okay, does not need to have any causal relationship with the independent or dependent. It is not required that it should be logically have any relationship with independent or dependent variable. Okay, for example, let us take this same example again, digital marketing and sales. How do you think uncertainty? Now we are in the COVID situation. If you see, due to this COVID situation, the sales means that the digital marketing is working more accurately and giving you more profits, because when you do digital marketing, sales have been increased. And this moderator means the situation of COVID or uncertainty we are facing nowadays, it is a moderator. Why it is a moderator? For example, now most of the time we are facing to our computers. We are using mobile devices more than ever, and we are using all these digital technologies high at the highest level. Okay, so it means that this situation compels us or force us to use these digital devices, and that is why the people who are doing digital marketing, they are more successful. So this relationship is being strengthened because of this uncertainty or this situation. And now you can see that even we are ordering food online and we'll try to get that food out of our house. We will not allow any people to come at our house, and then we'll go back to take that product and bring that virus with us. So that is something we should understand. During this process, uncertainty have largely strengthened the relationship between digital marketing and sales. That is how moderation it works. Let me give you another example. If you see, I give this example in the many classes. For example, when I have a class at 2 p.m., mostly everybody is present. But what about if my class is at 8 a.m. in the morning? So class timing is a moderator, because in the morning, mostly people, they would not be able to attend my class. So it means that the timing is also a moderator. It can play a very important role. Similarly, some other incident, for example, raining outside, that is also influence the attendance. So it means that these variables can strengthen the relationship. They'll act like a catalyst in your research. Okay, so this is moderator. So let me just briefly overview these two. Moderation is strengthen the relationship, and mediation is explains the relationship between dependent and independent variables. Okay, now this is something we understand One variable, I think I skipped that variable, that is control variable. The control variable is a variable which we are interested to control it, means that there is no effect passing through that variable. Or alternatively, that variable have no effect on your research, that is called a control variable. We use these control variable in many cases, but here for your level it is not required to go deep into the control variable. But you should understand, for example, if I am planning to work on the female empowerment, it means that the work gender would be a control variable, because I am taking only female, then there is no effect of gender on our research. Okay, so this is how we work with the control variable. Now the next question is how we define, operationally define the variable. So operational definition. Let me read this slide for you. An operational definition is the articulation of operationalize use in definition the term of a process needed to determine existing of an item or phenomena or its properties such as duration, quantity, extension in space and any other characteristic. But now let me make this definition very simple for you. For example, we have digital marketing. Now I took one example for you for digital marketing. The digital marketing is the use of internet to reach customers. Digital marketing is a broader field, influencing, attracting customer via email, customer marketing or content marketing or search platforms, social media and more. It means that digital marketing is marketing your product over any online or digital platform, that is called a digital marketing. Okay. Now this definition is, I took it from the internet, and you can also consider taking definitions of your variables from different researchers. So they are called conceptual definitions. Okay, so you can take the concept and the definition from the internet, from the other available resources. But this definition does not necessarily fit your research area or your scope. How? Let me explain. In my research, I'm interested to do or to study digital marketing. That is what I have already explained. But what if I'm just interested to study the digital marketing using Facebook and WhatsApp platform, not any other platform? Still, it is a digital marketing concept, but not all digital marketing platform. So let's rethink about the definition of digital marketing. Let me show you again. The digital marketing is use of internet to reach customer. Yes, we are doing that. Digital marketing is a broader field, including attracting customer via email. We are not doing that. Content marketing, that is maybe the possibility, because we are developing content that would be shown on Facebook and WhatsApp. Search platform, no, we are not using any search engines or any other media. Social media, yes, we are using only one platform for social media and many other options, but we are not using all the. So it means that the conceptual definition of digital marketing is different, but what we are using in our research may not be, or may be a subset of that definition. So how we operationally define our variable here? Now I will define my digital marketing is marketing of my product using internet or using Facebook or WhatsApp only. Okay, so in my research I will explain operationally. Okay, in my research, digital marketing is marketing the product on Facebook and WhatsApp. That is a very simple operational definition for digital marketing for my research. Okay, so you understand. Let's read this here. Marketing of our product or services using Facebook or WhatsApp, that would be my operational definition. Okay, now this is the point where you have to define your variable. From your research question, easily you can identify your variable, either they are dependent or independent, mediator or moderator, and then you have to operationally define every variable in your research. Okay, so it would be easy for readers to understand what are your operational definition mean, that what is the scope of your research and what are included or excluded in your research, and from here you will directly link these concepts with your questionnaire or scales which will be used to measure those variables. So please identify your operational definition here. Okay, let's move. Now, operational definition, we are very clear. Now, let's move on the theoretical development, how we develop theories and how we use theories to relate in our work and why they are very important. Now, when we are clear about our research question, we are clear about our fundamental concepts of dependent, independent and other variable, and then we have our operational definition. It is your time to understand what are the theoretical developments of your framework or of your research. Now let's focus on the theory first. What is the concept of a theory? Basically, theories are formulated to explain, predict and understand phenomena. In many cases, the challenges and extended existing knowledge within the limits of critical boundaries of assumptions. Okay, now let me make this sentence very easy for you. The theoretical development or theories are very important in gaining knowledge. When we do research, the objective is to extend the body of knowledge or to solve any existing problem. In both cases, we are trying to enhance the knowledge or understanding, our current understanding about some phenomena or some concept. Okay. Now, what we do when any new scientific investigation or new prediction or new claim happens in the world, they start it with the theory. For example, we all know that Newton's law of motion. Now, Newton's law of motion are valid and they are true laws, but when Newton presented these laws, they were theories. Okay. Now, the theories are the one we try to test or we try to prove it right or wrong again and again. So that's why theories are the claims or the prediction about some phenomena, and with the help of data, we always try to collaborate them, or we always try to predict them or prove them right or wrong. Okay. In the scientific research, mostly we deal with the laws because we have very accurate measurements of variables. Okay, for example, laws of motion, for example, gravitational force, for example, gravitational acceleration. So we have very accurate predictive measurements for all these concepts. That is why when we try to prove those theories right, and most of the researchers, they find similar answer, then these theories will become law. But in our research, especially in social sciences research, we mainly deal with the theories because we don't have a precise or very accurate measurements of the variable. That is why our concepts are still considered under theories. But still, theories are very important in understanding and formulating your knowledge and extending the body of knowledge. Okay. Now, why I'm telling you all this? Basically, when you start working on any relationship or any causal effect or any variable, it means that you are not the one who is thinking about that concept for the first time. Maybe you are the one who are thinking for the first time, but still it is important for us to investigate whether do we have any similar concept or similar theories already established. For example, if I'm working on digital marketing, so what I'll do, I'll try to search the theories, already established theories or established work from the other researcher, and I'll try to see whether they have done something similar to my work, and what are their assumption and what are their result, and then I will try to relate those assumption and those results with my framework or with my research. So that is theoretical framework. That is how we develop our theoretical framework. So how you need to do is, whatever is your area, you try to search and find out three or maybe more theories related to that particular topic, and try to link those theories with your understanding or with your current framework or with your current work. Okay, so that is how we develop theoretical framework in our research. Okay, now let's move to the next point. When we develop theoretical framework, it is also important to understand what is our conceptual framework. Now, conceptual framework is basically the graphical representation or relational representation of your work. you can use any graphical or illustration, graphical illustration or any other form of the representation of your variables and their relationship in a way that reader can understand easily. They can predict the relationship and they can predict your work easily. Okay, so this is some of the examples for your reference. If you can see, this is the same example I use in this work. So this can be the conceptual framework from this today's class, and then there are different types of the conceptual framework you can develop in any different form. Okay, so these all are basically to give an illustration, give an understanding and graphical representation to your ideas in order for other to understand what is your research all about. Okay, so this is how we develop conceptual framework. Okay, so conceptual framework is different and your theoretical framework is different. So theoretical framework is basically you have to identify the similar theories in your area and try to figure out how these research and these theories are related with your work, and are the basic assumptions are same which you are using, or they have used different set of assumptions. If the assumptions are same, then you have to rethink about your variable, or variables are same, or there the context of your work is same. So theories will give you perspective, will give you context in which you can develop your research finding or research framework. Okay, now this is for theoretical framework. For conceptual framework, it is very simple. You have to develop any graphical shape to clear your work or to convey your message to the readers easily. Okay, that is called conceptual framework. Okay, now with this I have completed my outcomes for this lecture. So you have already understand what are the variables and what are their different types, and then we discuss about the operational definition, and finally I discuss about the theory and conceptual framework. I hope so everybody understand. Now this is where you have to do your class activity. You have to find out what are the different variables involved in your research. That for that you can use your research question and highlight your variables, either dependent, independent, or any form of the variable, mediator, moderator, or any other parameters to be estimated. And then secondly, you have to define them operationally. You have to provide conceptual definition and then operational definitions of your variable. And finally, you can develop a conceptual framework from your variables to understand what are their logical relationships or causal relationships are. Okay, thank you very much. I hope so everybody understands today's lecture, and if there is any question you can ask me, and you can comment in the comment box. Thank you very much and have a very nice day.